My name is Taylor Leege, and I am a dry stone wall builder. What I'm doing here is rebuilding several retaining walls that have fallen over and needed some attention. So what dry stone walling or dry stone building is just building using stone without the use of mortar, hence dry. It relies strictly just on friction and gravity and proper placement to keep things together. But if you have to pick one, you go for structural stability versus the aesthetics. One thing you want to have for sure is good footwear. These happen to be something steel-toed. That way, just in case you happen to drop something on your foot, you're not going to have any injury. Even when it's warm, I like wearing long pants, something that has double material, especially on the knees and on the thighs where you're setting stones a lot. I do a lot of work with hammers and chisels and things like that too. And then you're going to want to wear safety glasses. You know, the first and most important is to put the length into the wall, meaning the long part of the stone goes into the wall. Second thing would be putting one stone over two or two over one, or crossing all the joints. So making sure that you're setting a stone over the space between the two below it. As you can see, there are some of these occasionally a really long stone that goes all the way through it, which is really important. That's called a through stone. And you put those roughly halfway up just to really bind the wall and keep it firmly planted. Other than that too, you also kind of taper the wall as it gets taller, meaning it gets slightly less wide as you go up. And then the other thing you really want to do is just make sure you're building everything level. Even if you're building on a slope, it's easy to want to put the stones to follow the slope that you're on, but you really want everything to be horizontal and level. You know, a wall or anything like that is really only as good as its foundation. You want to think about using the largest ones at the bottom, and then you slowly are kind of using smaller ones as you go up. And then you're trying to use the second biggest ones generally on the top. So it's almost like you've got this sandwich where you've got, yeah, really big at the bottom, next biggest at the top, and then you're kind of slowly using smaller stones up in between. You know, something like that might be decent to start with. And then I'll keep filling in with big ones, and then I'll take small ones to kind of fill in all those little areas too. You use bigger stones on the front, and if you look inside the wall, there's much smaller ones that I'm using to fill all of the gaps in here too. That stuff again is traditionally referred to as hearting. You really want to pack the inside of the wall tightly. You really want to individually place every one, make sure they don't move, and then you keep adding smaller ones until it's full. And that actually, more than anything, is what gives the wall its true strength. It can be a little bit tedious, but you really don't want to rush it. As far as time goes building into this, I've spent roughly, you know, maybe 20 hours of building time so far on this side. But I think the benefits are, you know, we get a lot of frost, we get a lot of heave here in Minnesota. You know, water freely drains through it. You don't get it trapped inside the wall where it can cause things to shift out of place. Renewable, I mean, something minor happens, something falls over, you can rebuild it.